Now, what's the most inappropriate thing, beginning with M, that the Pope has kissed? Yes, Sarah Millican.
My breasts.
Well, this has come as a shock to me. Tell the story. Where were you?
That's it. He sort of fell.
He fell on your breasts.
I was in, like, W.H. Smith's, and he covered to bless some Bibles or something, and he just tripped on because the carpet was... And I had a low-cut top, and I don't wear one for QI because it feels disrespectful.
Yes.
But I normally have them out, and he just landed, and because his natural inclination is to kiss things, you just kiss them.
Wow.
What was his reaction?
Did he like it?
He was pleased.
Did he go,
No, he was too polite for that, but I could see a little glint in his eye.
Anyway, a merkin. What's a merkin?
It's a pubic wig.
A pubic wig. Could a pope kiss a pubic wig? Is it likely?
If he was drunk enough.
On communion wine.
In a different way.
Well, we're getting back to the 17th century.
There's a tall lady.
I think you're going to like this man. There's an English highwayman called Captain Dick Dudley.
Dickie Dudley.
Dick Dudley. I think you're going to like Dick Dudley. He was hiding in Rome. And while he was hiding from the law enforcement officers, he bought a dead prostitute's pubic wig, a merkin, from an anatomist. He dried it well and combed it out, that's in inverted commas because it's a quotation, and sold it to the Pope. There they are. There's a selection of them.
Wow. I like the one in the bottom right. That's
yes,
excellent.
Good, nice curls.
Yeah. That's had a perm, that one.
So this was Anne Summers back in the day?
Yeah. Kind of.
My goodness.
He sold it to the Pope. Could have been Clement the X or Innocent the XI, as a piece of St. Peter's beard.
Well done,
Popes like relics. He's a great man. I like Dick Dudley.
Gullible the IV.
Yeah.
A beard, you say?
St. Peter. Exactly. The Pope put it on his mouth, kissed it multiple times, and appeared to be thrilled with his purchase. Dick was paid 100 ducats, and he immediately skedaddled it out of Rome before anybody caught up with him and could call his mouth. Bluff.